So let's start with the mistakes. So here is our source chart. The chart which actually, so what does it tell us? This bar chart presents comparison of the expenses, so capital expenses, personal expenses, and other type of operational expenses. And we are comparing last year values with the current budget, with the so current status. And looking at this chart as it is, as it in this its default form, we can notice one quite common mistake which I see that people are doing on their data charts, that they put there twice the same information. So there's a redundancy of information, and that concerns the values here. That information that this first column is 23% and the second one is 20 is actually written twice. Once it's written here, and second time it's written on the axis here. So we don't need both of information. And I'll show you a way how to decide which one to choose. Next mistake, which I see a lot, is that there is a missing meaning. Like there is a message. Usually every chart has some message. So this one can tell us, okay, we are almost on the same budget as last year, or we are spending less, depending what kind of month of the year it is. So we are missing the message, and that should be written, and I'll show you ways how to do it. Third mistake which I see a lot is the lack of focus on one thing. So if there is too many same visually important things on a slide or on a chart, it's not very good. It's better to focus attention to one point which is the most critical, or the point which you want to your reader to look at. Also, sometimes, not that often anymore, but still people are using this kind of 3D style for the charts, which is not very good practice because it doesn't give clarity to it. So this is over decoration, using this bevel style, this shines around. Also, in this case, I see the low contrast of the numbers over here. So the gray here on the blue, or the white on the light blue. These are not the best combinations. It's harder to be read this kind of chart. Also, try to avoid the 3D 3D charts. They look maybe nicer, but they don't. Still, this is kind of over decoration. Still, if I want to just pass the message, it's the best is used. This is the most simple one. One more mistake, which is good to be aware of, is to use the proper format of the chart. So, for example, this is line chart on the same values. However, this is not the proper use of the line chart, because line charts are to be used. You should use them when we have here on this axis some continuous variable. So time, for example, months, years, minutes. However, in this case, we are comparing three categories of expenses, and they are not continuously related. So we should not use this kind of chart. Coming back to the first chart over here, so you can see yourself, it's still better to do some few steps and in order to reach this kind of chart, which is more clear, more visible, and I'll show you the ways how to do it. So first, let's tackle the first issue which I mentioned, and that's this double information on the chart, so this red numbers here. The rule of the thumb, which can help you to decide which one to keep, because it's enough to keep one, is actually your audience. You should realize that, okay, what your audience is expecting from you to express. So are they really focused on specific numbers? Do they want to know specifically that this is 23% or 20? Or are they focused more just on the trend to know, okay, are we almost there? How much is it? So it's like 90% almost comparing to last year. Then it's enough just to keep the axis over here and remove this number here.